And the answer is that you can't tell. And this is a different type of combinatorial problem than the previous ones. In the previous ones, we had a fixed number of variables, and we knew how many combinations we had for each variable. In the zebra problem, there were 25 variables, and that's all there was, and we could enumerate all the combinations. For the pouring problem, we're trying to not fill static variables, but rather put together a sequence of actions to go from one state to the next. And we don't know how long that sequence is, and of course, at each point, we have six different options of different ways to go, and from each of those, six more. So we know it's going to be roughly six to the something, because we branch six at each point, but we don't know what that x is, because we don't know how long the sequence is. And so that makes the problem slightly different. If we want to be formal, we call it a combinatorial optimization problem, but usually we just call it a search problem.